finish worship online. We're so glad that you have logged in to join us tonight. We are celebrating, man, one of the most creative and unique and fun holidays on the Christian calendar, and that's Ascension Day. It's something that that is new to me since moving to Indonesia, and there's just so much I love about celebrating the ascension of Christ. And so let's do that tonight. We want to celebrate. We invite you, whether you're in your coast, you're at your home, you're with friends, or you're with your family, we want to take some time to just celebrate the Lord's presence. Hey, while we're worshiping, go ahead and make some comments, all right? Go ahead, and we want to be able to see who all is watching. You know, get the two hands, you know, going. You can pray, whatever it is. But let's give the thumbs up if you're feeling good. If I'm singing bad or you want a different song, do the thumbs down. You know, I don't know. But let's interact. Let's not make this just one-way communication. Let's make this a three-way communication, right? It's us, you, me, and the Lord tonight, all right? So we're going to do that now together. Would you pray with me as we get started? Father in heaven, we thank you for your goodness. And so we're grateful for the celebration of Hari Kanaika.
Yes.
For this Ascension Day celebration.
Yes,
so now,
Lord,
we commit these moments to you, that
yes,
you would be glorified, that your name would now be lifted high. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone says, amen. Hey, let's worship the Lord together. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless with awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all.
Yeah.
are joining us and we have these few moments to worship the Lord together. One of the things that I love about celebrating Ascension Day is I feel like it's like a tag team match. It's like, you know, Jesus comes and he shows us the way, right?
Yeah.
Then he is crucified for the sins of the world, for my sins, your sins. He's buried, resurrects from the dead, giving us victory over sin. Then he ascends to heaven, and it's like, I always feel like it's like a tag team match. He's like, okay, it's your turn now, all right? Like, I gotta go, but you stay.
Yeah.
You make this thing happen. You are now the messengers of grace and healing to a broken and hurting world. And so tonight, and if you're hurting tonight, and know that there's grace for you.
Yeah.
There's healing for you tonight. So as we sing this next song, I want you to just sing it by faith tonight. Trust God.
Turn it.
your eyes wherever you're at now and just say, oh God, I trust you, Lord.
Working, even when I don't feel it, you're working.
let's sing that bridge one more time. Because I think that's where a lot of us are at right now. We just need to believe that, man. That, man, even when I don't see it, you're working, God. Even when I don't feel it, man, you're at work. So this is not just a song of just lyrics to a song, man. This becomes a prayer of the prophetic. Say, God, this is my faith. This is what I'm standing on.
Yes.
And I'm believing in today.
Yes.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working.
We trust that you are working, Lord God.
Yes.
We know that you are making a way where it feels like there's no way, Lord Jesus. God, we ask that you would prepare our hearts for your word tonight and that you would speak to us in mighty, mighty ways. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, welcome, you guys. We are so glad that you're worshiping with us this evening. So it's my pleasure to get to introduce you to tonight's speaker. It's kind of fun because normally I'm the one who introduces her, or she's the one who introduces me, and now I'm the one who gets to introduce her. So we're gonna ask Rachel to come on up and share with us tonight in English. This is exciting.
All right.
Woo!
I'm a little nervous, but it's okay, I got it. Sorry, guys. Okay. Happy Ascension Day, guys! Yes! Okay, so if you don't know my name is Rachel. I'm the English worship staff here. So glad I have opportunity to share on Ascension Day service, English worship on Instagram. Boop. Okay, my story. I want to tell you a story about like my encounter with Jesus. Okay, so my first encounter with Jesus is when I was second grade of Center High School in the 4 hours intercession prayer meetings. Oh my God. I was a teenager at the time and I didn't like long prayers, you know. Someone pushed me to join that prayer meeting, but I'm so thankful someone pushed me to join to that prayer. So I had great encounter with God personally at the time. If there's no one like who pushed me, I don't know at the time, okay? That encounter made me commit to him. And I said, Jesus, if it's you, I will follow you. For me, choosing to follow him is simply making him the Lord of my life. All of my life. Choosing to follow him is simply going all in with everything I am and everything I do. In this Ascension Day, he reminds us again into the Great Commission. He said something important before he went to heaven. And in Matthew 28:18-20 said, Jesus came and told his disciples, I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commandments I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. This commission is kind of like the last words from our loved one, right? Like before they passed away, you know. That was the last words before Jesus left to the earth. Left to heaven, okay? Left from the earth. Okay, I mean like that. The last words must be so important for us to remember. And yeah, we will go all in for the last words that God said to us. In John 14:15 said, if you love me, obey my commandments. Now, his commandment is, go and make disciples of all the nation and baptizing them. God never asked you to be someone important or famous or rich. Yes, you can be like rich people. You can, okay? You can be famous. You can be a singer, you know? Famous singer is okay for you, okay? But this tension, not that thing, okay? So he didn't say go and be a famous singer or go and be a great teacher, be a great doctor. He asked us go and make, not be. Go as you are now and make disciples. So when you are a doctor, you will be a doctor who makes disciples. You will be the businessman who makes disciples. When you are a singer, you will be the singer who makes disciples. When you are the students now, make disciples. When you said, I don't know what to teach them, I don't know what to tell, or I'm not good enough, I said, it's okay. You don't need to be like great teacher, okay? It's enough for you to teach them to obey the commandment that God already have given you before. Remember, have given you before. You ever struggle with forgiveness? Now you can forgive people? Teach them how. You have been sick before and be healed? Tell them how God healed you. If you now can pray, okay, teach them how to pray. If you now lead the core group, oh yeah, core group, yeah, yeah, okay, or cell group, teach them how to lead core group. Yeah. If you ever struggle with temptation and win from it, tell them how you do it, right? Be all in is about with everything I am and everything I do. We already have the victory. Jesus already raised from the dead. He has the victory for us. And now, you need to do something from that victory. Yeah. It's go and make disciples of all the nations. The last point that stuck in my life, okay? 2 Timothy 2:4 said, soldier, don't get tied up in the affairs of civilian life, for then they cannot please the officer who enlisted them. When we go all in for God, you don't worry about what you eat, about what you will be, because you totally trust him about your life. Yeah. And you know that he will take care of your life. Yeah. It doesn't mean you to forget all your dreams, okay? It doesn't mean like that, okay? No, don't do that. I want to say, trust him. He knows your dream. He will give you open door for that. When I know God commands me to go, make disciples of all the nation and be a good shepherd of them who I serve, I said to God, yes, I'm in God. When he said, go to our Lord, I answered, yes, I will, God. Go to the place you don't like, yes, I will do, God. To the stranger remote place that I never been before, yes, I will. To the place that doesn't have Starbucks or mall, okay? I said, yes, I will. To the place that I need to cross the ocean with speedboat, which is just so scary in Tarakan with Katie, I said, yes, I will. Now, who wanna join me to go all in, guys? Remember, he said, I am with you always, yeah, even to the end of the age. Where will you go now? Ask God where you can go. I believe God will answer. Go to follow up your friends, yes. Go to tell your employees about Jesus, yes, good, go for it, okay. Go to finish your scripture and tell people how God helped you to graduate.
Yes.
Do it, okay? Go and make disciples. All right, let's pray about it. So we want to make God give me strength. God give me like the thoughts, like where we need to go, God. God, I believe that you will tell us and you give us strength wherever you want us to go. Give us courage. We know that we have weakness, but God, I believe that you already forgive us for all the weakness that we have. So God, we just surrender our life to you,
yes.
That we want to all in for you.
Yes.
Give us strength for that. Yes. Just we want to go out from our laziness or from our weakness, God. We want to go out from that. And want to tell that you are the one, that
yes,
you are the God,
Lord,
that we serve. That's so good to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thanks, Rach, for sharing that. Let's just spend a few moments receiving that word that God calls us into action. What is it that God is speaking you to do? Just say that, God, what do you want me to do? Thank you. reminded of when Rachel spoke. Matthew 28 says, go and make some disciples. And I was thinking, man, that this Ascension Day, man, it's a call to action. I mean, the gospel is always on the move. Jesus is always saying, hey, let's go. Let's do this. We rarely see Jesus say, stay, right? The only time I think he says, wait, is when he says, wait here for the Holy Spirit, which is going to give you the power to what? To go.
Yeah.
And so the gospel is an action.
Yeah.
And Jesus doesn't just stay. He ascends to heaven, and he says, okay, now you go.
Yeah.
It's your turn. So that's what we're about here. It's not about, hey, how many Bible studies can I join? Or I don't know enough. Man, it's the gospel's action.
Yeah.
And you might not feel like you know enough, that you're spiritual enough, that you're holy enough. But man, the gospel, Haughty Ascension, I can't think in English, Ascension Day, man, it's about action. Saying it's your turn. I've given you everything you need.
Yeah.
Everything you need to succeed. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working.
That you joined us today for Ascension Day. And yeah, I want to challenge you to go make disciples no matter where it is. I think we can get creative during this time where we have to stay at home. But God still wants to use each and every one of us.
Yes.
So let's continue to pray and ask Him to fill us with His Holy Spirit to go. So we have a few announcements before we actually go. And that is tomorrow at 10:30, we have the last day of our 10:30 challenge. It's been so fun and so challenging and encouraging to get to hear from different staff and core group leaders on how to pray. And I know that God has answered many of our prayers that we've circled in prayer throughout this last month. And so we're excited to hear about some of those testimonies tomorrow. Join us at 10:30 a.m., not p.m. And on Sunday, we're beginning a new theme. I don't know the exact title, but I know it's about the Holy Spirit. And so,
that is the title.
It's called the Holy Spirit. So join us Sunday morning at 10 a.m. or Sunday evening at 5 p.m. on ewchurch.online or something like that. Check out Instagram for the exact link. And continue to follow us and stay up to date on Instagram for all the other things happening this next week. We love you guys, and we're going to end in one more song, so let's continue to get our praise on.
Woo! Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Who loves
the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth.
We'll see you guys. Thanks for being